Coming up today, we look at how doping allegations in world athletics have spiraled into a scandal that is shaking the very foundations of the sport. Usain Bolt checks into Brazil as Rio 2016 gets on its mark, and we take a look at the athletes that will attempt to fly Uganda's tricolored flag high at the Rio Olympics.
The Olympic flame is lit for the 31st Summer Olympic Games in Rio de Janeiro.
That was 90 days ago. The Olympic flame, an important symbol of the Games, symbolizing peace, unity and friendship, was lit by Caterina Lehu from the rays of the sun at the Temple of Hera. A relay that has for 8 decades signaled the official countdown to the Olympics ensued with the Brazilian organizers receiving the flame on April 27th at a handover where the first modern Olympics were held in Panathenian Stadium. The Olympic torch relay has not been without incidents. Despite high security around it, it was extinguished by protesters in Rio de Janeiro last week. That has not been the only awkward moment that hosts Brazil have had to take on the chin. The threat of Zika virus has loomed over Rio 2016, forcing some athletes, notably tennis and golf stars, to pass the opportunity of featuring at the Olympics. Brazilian organizers will nevertheless be pleased by the sight of this man. Usain Bolt arrived at the tail end of last week. The world's fastest man will be seeking an unprecedented triple-triple and found some kind of form at the London Anniversary Games after an injury-plagued season. There will also be a first when 10 athletes represent a refugee Olympic team. The team will have an Ethiopian, 3 South Sudanese, 2 Syrian and 2 Congolese athletes.
Not many countries actually qualify athletes. And look, so far we have 15 who have qualified. This is a record. Uganda has never taken more than 13 athletes to Olympic Games. The highest ever has been 13 in 1988 Seoul Olympic Games. That's when we had 13 track and field athletes.
While Team Uganda has broken a record it set at Seoul 1988, World Athletics governing body IAAF is working around the clock to ensure that what happened at those games in this final never see daylight.
All set. Away. Johnson, a great start. Lewis, not too bad. Stewart away well. Johnson in front. Lewis coming at him. Johnson's got a great lead. He's going to win. Ben wins. Johnson. And the time is...
3 days after winning the 100 meters final, Ben Johnson was disqualified and his then world record time of 9.79 seconds expunged after the Canadian's urine and blood samples tested positive for stanozolol. The anabolic steroid enhances performance by improving muscle growth and red blood cell production. It also improves nitrogen retention while helping one retain lean muscle mass. Just under 3 decades on from the Ben Johnson debacle, World Athletics finds itself grappling with doping that has touched epidemic proportions. The International Olympic Committee, or IOC, has set out to make a feast of it by doubling its budget for pre-Olympic testing. IOC has also extended its reanalysis program for Beijing 2008 and London 2012, while coming down hard on countries whose programs are deemed non-compliant by the World Anti-Doping Agency, or WADA. Russia, who have been red-flagged for systemic state-sponsored doping, shall not field track and field athletes at the Olympics. Kenya has also found itself on a knife edge after it was recently declared in breach of global anti-doping rules. Although Kenya is one of the major forces in world athletics, it has stained its reputation with a string of failed drug tests. 18 Kenyan athletes are serving bans for doping, totaling 55 years. The president of Athletics Kenya says it will take a concerted effort to decisively deal with the growing problem of athletes using performance-enhancing drugs.
We have combined with the Ministry of Education, and we are doing all that there is. We have trained a lot of teachers so that they can follow up even the children in school. We are working very closely with the government. We are working very closely with the Ministry of Health. We are working very closely with the Ministry of Sports. And so it's a combined effort. It's not just Athletics Kenya.
The worry is that the growing problem of doping reportedly playing out in Kenya's high-altitude training centers could rub onto Uganda's distance runners who pitch camp there. Uganda Athletics Federation's top official thinks otherwise.
We've talked to Stephen many times, and he knows what is at stake. I doubt so much whether Stephen can get mixed up with the issues of doping, because he's somebody focused and he knows what he's doing. He has gained experience and he knows what he's doing. I believe he cannot be diverted.
As IOC pledges to clean up the sport, athletes that descend on the Brazilian chief port of Rio de Janeiro will be hoping for a leveled playing field. Uganda will field 21 athletes at the Olympics. Stephen Kiprotich will put his marathon title on the line. Joshua Cheptegei will also go in the 10,000 meters final with two other compatriots. Uganda will also field a record number of female athletes. Seven of them shall go in six different events. That's it from Rio Deal today. You can catch updates and progress reports about Team Uganda's performance at Rio 2016 on NTV Sport and NTV Weekend Support. Until then, goodbye.